Lebanon's Prime Minister spoke about what it's like to be surrounded by war. The conflict in Syria has raged on for over 7 years now, and it has deeply affected this country. With Assad troops now closing in on victory, I asked the Prime Minister what the end of the war in Syria would mean for Lebanon.
I think Russia would have made its point, and Russia controls Syria. So we will deal with the Russians.
What is your relationship like with Russia?
Very good, perfect. I have a very good relationship with Russia, and I have a good relationship with President Putin that I respect very much. And I believe that we somebody we can work with.
So you don't think you will have to deal with Bashar al-Assad?
I'd rather you deal with President Putin.
So Prime Minister Hariri says he will be dealing with Russia rather than with the Syrian regime. And I asked the Lebanese Prime Minister about another world leader, one that he seems to get along really well, the U.S. President Donald Trump.
I think President Trump is somebody who is very clear. He says something, he does it. The issue where we had a problem in the past is we didn't know what was the policies. At least today, I know what is the policy. At least I know today how to work out around this policy or with this policy. And at least there's somebody we can talk to and convince them about our situation.
But this interview wasn't only about foreign policy. Saad al-Hariri also spoke about the challenges he is facing here in Lebanon. This country held parliamentary elections this year for the first time in almost a decade. But Hariri has yet to form a new government, and this political uncertainty hasn't helped the economy, which has been staggering for years now, and it desperately needs reforms, something that can only happen with a new government. I asked the Prime Minister what he was ready to do to make sure this impasse is solved, and he said, well, he will have to work with everybody, and that includes Hezbollah.
We have political differences. Hezbollah knows that, and I know that. They will never accept my policies vis-a-vis, you know, the Gulf or the, and I will never accept their policy vis-a-vis Iran and other stuff. But it does not mean that we should stop the country from functioning.
Saad al-Hariri also spoke about what prompted him to resign last year, a move that sent shockwaves across the region. He said he wanted to shock, he wanted to shake things up here in Lebanon. He says that at least for now he has reached that objective. Things seem to be back on track. He still needs, of course, to form that government. He says he will be working hard to do just that so he can implement the reforms Lebanon so badly needs. Anelise Borges in Beirut, Lebanon, for Euronews.